Hey guys, what's going on? This is Atharva here, and today we are going to talk about how to get your first client as a developer. A lot of people ask this question all the time, so I decided let's just make a video for this. And if you like this video, just drop a like and just subscribe to the channel, because I'll be bringing more content like this. So first of all, you need to make some decent project with whatever programming language you are using. So I'm saying this because you don't have any past work experience and your projects count for that. So the clients usually look at your projects, and if they gain your trust, they'll just hire you. It's all the trust game. You need to gain that trust, and that's how you do it when you are landing your first client as a developer. Secondly, have it in your mind. You must have a portfolio. Every developer must have a portfolio, and the reason is that when your client visits your portfolio, it tells a lot about you already. So how to go with portfolio? So there are a lot of things you need to keep in mind while making your portfolio. The first thing is the domain name. And many developers just put up their portfolio on Heroku or Netlify, and their domain names are just herokuapp.com or netlify.com and anything else like that. And that's not good. That's look unprofessional, and that tells a lot about how you care about your things. So you must have a professional domain name. Like, it's cheap nowadays. You can just purchase it for 1 year and it will just go, and it's super cheap. And the second thing is that you don't need to waste a lot of time in your portfolio. I'll say that go for WordPress, like, it's so easy. What you want to do is you need to invest your time in something more worth. So I will suggest that you can go with making new projects, but the portfolio should be a whole lot easier to make. You don't want to spend a lot of time making it. So even if you use WordPress, it's going to be a lot easier, and there are built-in themes to do that, but it's totally up to you. If you can make a better one with Scratch, you can just go for it. But remember to keep your portfolio simple. And that's because the client will not navigate your page until they find what you make. And another thing is, please, please, please don't apply ads on your portfolio. I have seen some people who just apply ads on their portfolio, and that looks bad. That really looks bad. Like, there are no exception. Ads look bad in any web page. Just keep away from ads. You are not monetizing your portfolio, because that portfolio is your first ever project that your client will see. That should be amazing, no doubt in that. So work on your portfolio right now. Then you must make accounts at every social platform available. So why do I say this? Because you need to be visible in every place where the people just look and scroll around in social media. So you just need to drop some insane value bombs in your social media accounts, and that's how you gain followers, and that's how you sometimes gain client. And because people usually just look around for such people who are just dropping huge value bombs, and you gain trust like this. So you might get a lot of clients by this method. And once you are on every social media app on this planet which ever existed, people have to contact you. There are no exception. If they see you on every app, they have to contact you. So just go ahead and make social media accounts and start dropping value on each of them. Then I would say just connect to people on LinkedIn. So LinkedIn, many people just call it as a meme. Like, people just say it's a giant meme, but I would just disagree. It's not a meme. If you keep the memes aside for a minute and just look at LinkedIn carefully, you will see that many people get opportunities through that. Many people make some valuable connections with us, and people get a lot of opportunities from that. You can also gain some recommendations using LinkedIn, and it's all a testimonial system. You can also ask your clients to drop some testimonials on LinkedIn, and then people will see it, and there are high chances that people will start contacting you for work. Finally, start applying on platforms like Upwork and Freelancer. So I know many people will just start freaking out, like, I don't get clients there, and it's a disaster. So I would say, like, no one gets client in their first try. Just go ahead and try, keep applying to several things, and like, people just apply for 500 gigs and they get selected for one. That's the thing. You need to get some good reviews on those platforms to get some good clients, and once you have those reviews, you will not see yourself having some problem gaining some clients there. And if you want to start, you can just go with Fiverr. It's also a good platform. Or you can even search on Indeed. Like, you will see that Indeed is a job platform, but if you just go and search contract jobs, it just means the same. Like, you can just find some good places even there on Indeed, and I would recommend Indeed, of course. And you can also apply on LinkedIn. I mean, the LinkedIn job is very underrated. You can just go ahead and search any opportunities which you can get. But you need to just apply like 1500 places in a day, and maybe then you will just get selected in one. But never give up. You just need to keep applying to these places. So that was it for this video. If you like this video, just remember to hit the like button, and you can also support me by clicking the subscribe button. I would really appreciate that. And that's the way you can support me on YouTube. So I'll see you in the next video.